Hello designers, if you follow today's tutorial, you'll learn how to design this flat illustration in just a few steps using Illustrator CC.
To get started, download the exercise files, which includes the sketch and the vector files for free. The link is in the description of this video. Now once you open up Illustrator, make sure to disable Snap to Pixel and have Smart Guides enabled. Hitting Command R will add the rulers, not sure if we need them, but it's good to have them there. I drag the sketch image on the canvas, hold the down shift to keep the ratio right, and place it somewhere around the middle of the canvas. While you have the layer selected, you can go to the transparency tab and lower it to somewhere around 20%. You can then create a new layer where we'll start adding the shapes, but before doing that, lock the sketch layer up so you won't accidentally select it. Double click to rename it and select the pen tool to get started. We'll do the outlines first, so for that we don't need a fill. Bump up the size of the stroke to 5 pixels. Start with the hair. Click and drag to adjust the curvature of the path and try to follow along with the initial sketch as close as possible. For the face, we'll do the same thing. One thing to mention is not to worry if your paths are imperfect. We'll fix that in a bit. Won't be using the pen tool for the rims of the glasses. Select the round rectangle tool and draw some circles. You can adjust them to fit while holding down the Alt key and make a duplicate. Once you're done with the face and the hair, select everything and go to the stroke panel where you can select a rounded cap and a rounded corner option. You might see paths like this from time to time. Take the direct selection tool and adjust their position so they won't overlap. If you want a clearer look, hit Command Y and you enable the outline view. This makes it a whole lot easier to see if there are any paths going over each other. Now, remember what I said about you worrying about weird looking paths? Take the smooth tool and go over every single one. I usually do multiple passes on each one. I have no idea how it works, but I love the results. It's time to assign a color to all of those strokes. Click and drag and select all of them and double click here to get the color picker. I want to go for a saturated blue. Just till you're happy and hit OK. Go to the swatches panel and save it as a global color. That way you'll be able to change it later. The final colors will also be included in the exercise file, so you can find them there. It's time to add the background, create a separate layer group and name it background. Draw a rectangle that covers the whole canvas. We'll need to get rid of the blue stroke of this shape, and before assigning a color, make sure to disable the sketch since we don't need it anymore. Double click on the swatch and find the right one. Using the pen tool, we'll add some wavy shapes to define the illustration. This first one is for the sweater. Just like the previous video, I'll use a basic blue, yellow and red color scheme. Select it and this particular shape will be yellow. You can use the same color to create more reflections in the glasses. And behind all of the elements of the face, I would like to add the white shape. This shape will be need to send back to do that once you're done tracing. Make sure to select it and hit Command left bracket a couple of times to send it back. My favorite part is the hair, so create a red shape and just like the yellow one, have waves on the left hand side to simulate a shadow. There's no real instruction on how to do it or why do I do it. Try to have it as close as possible to my result. Close down the path and start moving it behind other elements. Would also like to have a shape on the arm as well. Hopefully this shape will give the illustration a bit more balance in terms of color. We have a lot of red and yellow, but let's change it to the background color. I found a place to use the light blue right at the color. Now I'm ready to move to the background, but you can add similar wavy shapes in all four corners. For two of them, I will change the color to yellow. And now I'm ready to mask everything out. Instead of using the shape builder tool, I'll group everything together and draw a rectangle on top of those elements that I can use to mask. Select both groups and hit Command 7. Even though it's the end of the process, I like to fine-tune the colors. To do that, double-click on the one you'd like to change, make sure that the preview box is checked, and then you can see your adjustments apply to every shape that has that particular global color. I really hope you've enjoyed watching this video tutorial, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. If you have any comments, leave them in the comment section below. And till next time, take care, everybody. Bye.